Hey guys, Kim Wolf here with the review of Hiccup's shield, and this is a pretty cool shield. It comes with an arrow and a map. I cannot find the map, sadly, so I won't be able to show you the map. There's a little slit here for the map, and there are little clip-ons for the arrow that you can hold the arrow onto, so you want to do a surprise attack on someone. And the arrow has a soft tip, it's pretty squishy. Here, let me show you. Squishy arrow. Yeah, it won't really make much damage. I can smack myself in the face a lot, doesn't really hurt at all. It won't hurt. Even if you hit someone in the eye, it's probably not even going to hurt. Don't try doing your thing backwards, because this end could hurt, and it would probably just break your shield. As you can see, there's a little button on the side that opens your shield into the crossbow. And I will do a little crossbow review. So if I kneel down here, I can do crossbow. Thing opens up like that, and it shoots like that. It hit my headphones, so we didn't go that far. So I'll shoot again from the same position. You can see really how far it goes. It doesn't go that far. Oops, that failed. That was my fault. The thing is pretty good when shooting, it's just having a little bit of trouble right now. Come on. Whoa. Well, that went all the way onto the floor. That shot pretty far. I'd say at most it will shoot about 10 feet. It's not really something you'd use in a little war. I'd say if you have someone else who has this and their arrow is hitting your shield, you should be fine as long as they don't hit it too hard. There's a little, as I showed you, there was a little map slip. Arrow holders on top and bottom. There's only one map slit. Don't yank the map all the way in there. It will get stuck. So I shoved a little bit of Play-Doh inside of here to keep it from going all the way. It made it a little slow to open, but it was pretty good after a while. Just takes a few minutes. Don't recommend it, though. I just did it because it was very irritating. And also, I have an Astrid costume on only because I wanted to stick with the theme here. So I guess you could see it. I guess I'll show you my Astrid costume. That's the skirt, because I know you couldn't see that well. That's the shirt, and shoulder pads. A little capey thing here that I'll show you. If you just unhitch this little thing, it has a little cape. Oops. From that view, it's a little cape. There's also a hood. I don't know why there's a hood. Oh, this is from the How to Train Your Dragon 2 movie. So it's a little bit updated. Well, that's that. And that was a quick Hiccup Shield review. Hope you have fun. And just a note. However, this thing may be dragon-proof, it is not pillow-proof or anything else-proof. Don't try throwing things at it. It is a hard plastic, but it's not that hard. So, if I were to throw this pillow at it, which I've done before, actually, don't judge me, it would probably get a little damage. It probably wouldn't break completely, but it might not open or something. Something would jam, maybe. I don't recommend it. So, this thing, I know it sounds weird that it may not be pillow-proof, yet it's dragon-proof, but if there's ever a dragon invasion or something, which there won't be, don't recommend using this. It's plastic. I recommend using a trash can lid more than this as far as shielding things. This is just for play. It adds great to a costume. Hope you enjoy your shield. Thanks for watching. Like, comment, subscribe if you love this review. I reviewed everything about the shield. Thanks for, except for the map. Thanks for watching. Bye. Like, comment, subscribe.